Jeremiah chapter 4. If thou wilt return, O Israel, saith the Lord, return unto me. That's repenting. That's what repenting means. It's a turn. And if thou wilt put away thy abominations out of my sight, then shalt thou not remove. And by the end of Jeremiah, they are removed, so they did not get rid of the abominations. And thou shalt swear, the Lord liveth, in truth, in judgment, and in righteousness. And the nations shall bless themselves in him, and in him shall they glory. That's the millennium. For thus saith the Lord to the men of Judah and Jerusalem, break up your fallow ground, and sow not among thorns. Now the thorns were a result of the curse, Genesis 3. So, we saw in Matthew 13, verse 3, and Mark chapter 4, verse 3, that's the word of God. Circumcise yourselves to the Lord, and take away the foreskins of your heart, ye men of Judah and inhabitants of Jerusalem, lest my fury come forth like fire, and burn that none can quench it, because of the evil of your doings. And their hearts are wrong. Their hearts are not right. Their hearts have a growth on them, and it's wickedness. And God's reaching out to them and saying, listen, if you don't get right, you're going to get judgment. You're going to get fire. You're going to get pain and suffering. Declare ye in Judah, and publish in Jerusalem, and say, blow ye the trumpet in the land. Cry, gather together, and say, assemble yourselves, and let us go into the defense city. Set up the standard toward Zion. Retire, stay not, for I will bring evil from the north and a great destruction. Be Babylon. Get ready for a battle. The lion has come up from his thicket, and the destroyer of the Gentiles is on his way. He is gone forth from his place to make thy land desolate. He's going to come into the land three times. And the third time, he's going to just wipe it all out. And thy city shall be laid waste without inhabitant. For this gird you with sackcloth, lament and howl. For the fierce anger of the Lord is not turned back from us. Ain't going to quit. It shall come to pass at that day, saith the Lord, that the heart of the king shall perish, and the heart of the princes, and the priests shall be astonished, and the prophet shall wonder. Then said I, O Lord God, surely thou hast greatly deceived this people and Jerusalem, saying, ye shall have peace, whereas the sword reaches into the soul. And at that time shall it be said to this people and to Jerusalem, a dry wind of the high places, where they've been worshiping, in the wilderness toward the daughter of my people, not to fan, nor to cleanse, even a full wind from those places, go back to the high places, shall come unto me. Now also will I gather sentence against them. You know, this wind is not going to be for good. It's going to be for wickedness. The places where they're worshiping. It would be amazing if God passes judgment in America on all the places where they worship gods. In the name of God, of course. Behold, he shall come up as clouds. His chariot shall be as a whirlwind. Nahum chapter 2, verse 4. His horses are swifter than eagles. Woe unto us, for we are spoiled. That's when they come in and take things. And you find that in you'll find that in Lamentations. O Jerusalem, wash thy heart from wickedness. He said earlier, take away the foreskin, now wash your heart. It's a heart condition. That's why a psychiatrist cannot help you. He doesn't deal with your heart. The heart is wicked above all things. He deals with the head. Man's condition that is wrong is his heart. And people say, follow your heart. That's the worst thing to do. For out of the heart is the abundance of sin. That thou mayest be saved. How long shall thy vain thoughts lodge within thee? For a voice declares from Dan, and publish affliction from the Mount Ephraim. Dan is the furthest north you can get in Israel. Make ye mention to the nations, behold, publish against Jerusalem, that the watchers come from a far country, Lamentations 4:17, and give out their voice against the cities of Judah. No good news coming. They'll publish what they say in the newspaper racket. There's no good news coming. As the keepers of a field, are they against her round about? Because she has been rebellious against me, saith the Lord. This is the enemy outside the city. Thy way and thy doings have procured these things unto thee. Procure is to get. This is thy wickedness, because it is bitter, because it has reached unto thy heart. Israel has a heart condition. My bowels, I am pained at my very heart. My heart maketh a noise in me. I cannot hold my peace, because thou hast heard, O my soul, the sound of the trumpet, the alarm of war. The sound of the trumpet today would be the air horn in major cities. Air blast warning, nuclear warning, air raids. Destruction upon destruction, so not just destruction, utter destruction is cried. For the whole land is spoiled. Suddenly are my tents spoiled, that's their home, and my curtains in a moment. How long shall I see the standard, that's the flag, and hear the sound of the trumpet, that's the cavalry coming. For my people is foolish, they have not known me. They are Scottish or sottish, which is dull, stupid, or very foolish. God, how cruel are you? Children, they have none understanding. And understand, remember, understanding is your relationship to God, of what you know and what wisdom you have. They are wise to do evil, America, but to do good they have no knowledge. So there's knowledge, understanding, and wisdom. They don't have no understanding of God because their wisdom is evil and their knowledge is not to do good. I beheld earth, and lo, it was without form. And there's various things about this. Say that this is the between Genesis 1:1 and 1:2, and void, and the heavens, they had no light. Revelation 16:10. I beheld the mountains, and lo, they trembled, and all the hills moved lightly. Some kind of earthquake kind of thing. And I beheld, and lo, there was no man. And all the birds of the heavens were fled. I don't know if there were birds here in the Genesis 1:1 and 1:2. I beheld, and lo, the fruitful place was a wilderness, and all the cities thereof were broken down at the presence of the Lord. Were there cities? Genesis 1:1 and 1:2. The first city mentioned in the Bible is Genesis chapter 4, from Cain, Enoch, and by his fierce anger. I think he's talking about the city of Jerusalem. I could be wrong. For thus hath the Lord said, the whole land shall be desolate, yet will I not make a full end. He's going to destroy, but he's going to have a remnant. For this shall the earth mourn, and the heavens above be black, because I have spoken it, I have purposed it, and will not repent, neither will I turn back from it. Now, at the end of the tribulation period, there's darkness. There's major earthquakes. The whole city shall flee from the noise of the horsemen and the bowmen, armies. They shall go into the thickets and climb upon the rocks. Every city shall be forsaken, and not a man dwell therein. When thou art spoiled, that's when the enemy comes in and takes what they want. What wilt thou do? Though thou clothest thyself with crimson, riches, good costly colors, though thou deckest thee with ornaments of gold, though thou rentest thy face with painting. Oh, there's that face painting again. I just recognize that now. In vain shalt thou make thyself fair. Thy lovers, they're painting their faces and they're in defeat. That'd be a war paint. Thy lovers will despise thee. Egypt, Syria. They will seek thy life. They're going to kill you. Edom. For I have heard a noise as a woman in travail. And that's always a reference to the tribulation. Here, the nation of Judah in Jerusalem, when Babylon comes in, and a question mark to Revelation 12, verses 4 and 5. And the anguish as of her that bringeth forth her first child, the voice of the daughter of Zion that bewaileth herself, that spreadeth her hand, saying, woe is me now, for my soul is weary because of murderers. There's another sin.